In this class, we learn how to make pattern in Illustrator by using pattern tool. For pattern creation, I place some icon, a bird, sun, and a house. And by using these icon, we create a custom pattern and a color swatch. We use this color for shirt background. So first I make some changes in the layer panel. So I go to layer tab and I show you in this layer, these icons and color swatch is placed. So you can check. And in this layer, shirt front and back is placed. So first I create two duplicate copy of this shirt layer by click and drag into new button. So click and drag and duplicate copy of this layer is created. First I off the visibility for this copy layer and then select this original layer and change the shirt background color. So first I select this and ungroup. Select again and check it's a group or not. So ungroup again, same as I select this shirt back and ungroup and check once again. Okay, so ungroup process is complete. Now I select this shirt body, choose eyedropper tool and then pick this color. Shirt body color is updated now, but stroke is gone. So I go to property tab and then change the stroke parameter. I choose 1 point. And same as I fill this color on the sleeve, collar and yoke. So first select this sleeve, pick eyedropper tool and by pressing control key you can toggle between eyedropper tool and selection tool. So by using selection tool, select this and pick this color. I zoom little bit and select yoke. Collar, I think collar is in a group, so right click or you can double click also, but you are not able to pick this color, so double click outside and select this color, double click on the fill color and choose this color code, copy, okay, and then select this collar, double click on this. Now select this stitching line, make sure it fill with no color and zoom little bit and now I select this collar, double click on the fill color, paste this color code, so this color will update now. Same as I update color for this, so I select this, pick this color, I think it should be little dark, so double click on this and choose a dark shade, okay, and double click outside to exit from the editing mode and select this stitching line and fill with no color, and same as I select this, fill with no color and replace the color for this. Now I select this button and choose a dark color for buttons. Okay, same as I replace color for shirt back, so I select this, fill with this color, press control key, select and replace color. Now I select these buttons and pick this color, same as I select this and replace this collar color also. Shirt color is update now. Now I select these and make a group, so right click, choose group, same as I select this and make a group. And it's time to create a pattern, so select all three icon, I zoom little bit and then go to object, pattern, click on the make. A notification is displayed here. The new pattern has been added to swatches panel. So swatches panel also automatically opened. Click on the OK button. In this rectangle, these are original icon and these are repeated copy of this pattern. I zoom out little bit and these are repeated copy and you can control the number of repeated copy by this parameter copies. By default 5x5 is selected, or you can also choose 3x3 or 7x7 and other option also available. I choose default 5x5 grid, and in the other parameter tile type, by default grid is selected. So this icon arrange into a grid form, and you can also choose other pattern. Brick and hex also available here for row and column. If you want to increase the spacing between these icons, so you can choose height and width parameter. Make sure this link is checked, and then click here and increase the value by scroll wheel. So spacing is increased now. After make all these changes, click on the done button to create a pattern. When you click on this, a new icon is displayed here, and it's a pattern. Now I on the second layer. So I go to layer panel and then on this. Now I off this bottom layer and make some changes here and delete duplicate object. First I delete this buttons, ungroup first. So you can select and delete. Okay, and then select, actually it's a group, so right click, ungroup, select this stitching line and delete, and make a unite object. So I go to pathfinder and unite and delete this color. So make these changes, and you can also merge them, but no need. Now I group this. I think we have to delete these stitching line because these are duplicate object. Now I select these and apply this pattern. Okay, pattern is applied, but I think the size of this pattern is very big. So select this, right click, choose transform, scale, and scale flyout is displayed here. Make sure transform object checkbox is unselected, and click on the preview button and change the uniform value from here. By default 100 is selected here. I choose 44 and then click on the OK button. Now I update this icon. So I choose eyedropper tool, pick this, so texture is update now. Same as I select this by pressing Ctrl key and update. Also on the cuff. Okay, now I select this and make a group. I think it's not a group. Yes. Same as I make changes on this shirt back. So first right click, ungroup, and delete the stitching line. I think it's also a group. And unite this boris and shirt body. And you can also delete this buttons. Okay, after these changes, apply this pattern by using eyedropper tool and then group. Okay, now I own the visibility of second layer. So select this and texture is updated. I close this swatches panel. So it's a final result of our button down shirt with the custom pattern.